How are you? Are you emotional about all this, or you're okay?
Oh yeah, no. Hey, listen. This is the way. Nothing you can do. Let me put it this way. If you can get fired by the Boston Bruins, you can get fired by anybody.
Talk about a cherry bomb. That was Don Cherry sounding off to our very own Joe Warmington on his firing from Rogers, a star of Coach's Corner, after his controversial comments about immigrants not wearing poppies. Let's take a look at what Don Cherry said.
You people love you that come here, whatever it is, you love our way of life, you love our milk and honey. At least you could pay a couple of bucks for poppies or something like that. These guys pay for your way of life that you enjoy in Canada.
I'm here with Joe Warmington, who broke the news. Joe, first off, do you think that Grape should have been fired?
Absolutely not. He didn't say anything wrong. You said right in that intro his comments about immigrants, which he didn't say. And so people are channeling what he's, you know, what they think he was supposed to say that he didn't say, and he got fired for that, which is ridiculous.
Do you think it was too much of the woke culture seeping into the ice?
They've had the knives out for Don Cherry for 20 years. I cover him. He's my beat, so I know that. And this is their biggest ever get, and they think that they've got him. I don't know, man. We'll see where this really goes, because this is not right.
Do you think, I don't think he shouldn't have been fired. I think he should have been a lot more careful. But, I mean, the thing is, he's like the only guy on Canadian television with any personality at all. So, you spoke with Grapes. Now, you're the only person to have spoken with Grapes, so this is exclusive. What did he say to you?
Well, he's pretty disappointed. I mean, he's obviously surprised that they would do this to him. He's made a lot of money for people over the years. He's very surprised that Ron McLean wouldn't have stood up for him. They all know Don. This is Don speak. And, you know, these people that are calling, you know, myself racist and Don Cherry racist, at least have something racist said before you get to be, you know, lose your career and your legendary status because of something that they think that he was going to say. And I'll tell you why I know that that's not what he meant, because I talked to him the night before about this very subject, and I wrote a column in Saturday's paper. And he said all of that to me in a very, very clear and cogent way. And, you know, obviously it could have come out better on Hockey Night in Canada. It didn't come out the way he'd like it to, but it's not a firing offense.
No, I agree with you. Do you think that this is going to be the last we've seen of Don Cherry?
No.
Or do you think he's going to rise up like a phoenix?
I think he's the biggest star in TV. I think he's the biggest free agent in TV. Maybe we should get him here at TorontoSun.com. Nelson Branco, come on, get on the phone. You know what? Tell me anybody hotter in TV right now. Wouldn't you want to have those ratings on Saturday night to have him come back with after Ron McLean stabbing him in the back? You imagine that tension?
Don't you think it's a bit ironic, Joe, that Don was fired on Remembrance Day? Do you think any good can come of this at all?
Absolutely. He's fired on Remembrance Day fighting for poppies. And I think the good that can come from this, and Don himself has said this, is that it might mean more poppy sales.
How appropriate, though, that I get fired on Remembrance Day. Yeah.
So fighting over poppies.
Yeah, fighting. And Ralph Melody, my ex-boss, said, I'll tell you one thing, I bet you the poppy sales have grown.
And that, you know, is a derivative of what's happened here. And that's what he was talking about. So maybe there is something good out of it. I still think that there's a chance that if the public want Don Cherry back on Coach's Corner, we got Ron McLean back a few years ago when they did this. Maybe we can get Don back, but it's up to you out there. Let me know if you want to help get him back.
Everybody in the country's talking about this. Let us know what you think. For the Toronto Sun, I'm Brad Hutter, and this is Joe Warmington.